Good day, folks. This is Greg Judy coming at you from Central Missouri. Opening morning of Missouri for spring turkey season. Sitting back here in the middle, what we call the woolly woods. This is the chunk of timber. When you go into it, you need a compass. If you get in the middle of it, you may not come back out without a compass. I just had a gobbler up this logging road in front of me. He gobbled about probably 3 minutes ago. I've got another gobbler off to my right. Over here, there's a little bottom right down there, and he just gobbled. It's a little talk back here. There was a squirrel over there just raising cane a while ago. And I've seen them scold turkeys when they're strutting. They just really go after them. Got a Canadian goose in the background. Beaver Lake. Oh, I saw him go down over there. Sometimes turkeys will gobble at geese. They get really crazy like that. This turkey in front of me, he's got about six hens with him. They were just raising cane this morning. So, going to be pretty doubtful. I can call him down this logging road toward me. Although I just saw something up through there. What is that? There's something moving. I think it might be a hen. In talking to you. Kind of get her fired up. The boss in will come towards you and sometimes she'll draw the gobbler with her. But you really got to get her fired up. There's a big lake up there. The one that's got the beavers in it. They're trying to build another dam I saw the other day. They're going to raise the water clear up on the top of the dam. I wish we could persuade them to leave. Afraid we're going to lose that dam on that lake. I put this blind up about 2 weeks ago. Just so the turkeys would get used to it, or everything would get used to it. Got another shitty knoll here. Back behind me is another one. That's actually a bird's foot trefoil out there. It's a legume. Turkeys love it. Attracts a lot of insects. Makes a really good grazing for deer and cattle and turkeys. Gobbler's got so many hens with him, he doesn't care what I holler at him. He's not gonna. probably not going to come down that road. He was close enough this morning that I could hear him drumming and strutting. When he flew out of the tree, he sounded like a 747 coming out of there. I mean, there was limbs busting and cut thump when he hit the ground, you could hear. And then the hens, they were much lighter. You could hear them popping out of the trees. A turkey's not a graceful thing coming out of a tree. But boy, are they smart. This gobbler off to my right would get him kind of mouthing going. He might get this other one gobbling. Maybe I could get him to come in here in front of me. Try and run one or the other. I think this bird in front of me is a dominant gobbler. He's got all the hens with him. The one on the right, I haven't heard any hen talk down by him at all. So he might be more vulnerable actually to call in. There's 160 acres of beautiful white oak right here. And the landowner just had a TSI done this winter. As you can see, these logs laying on the ground. They came through and cut out all the little trees that were competing with the nicer oaks. A lot of hickory they cut out. Any tree that had a nasty little bend to it that wasn't going to make a saw log, those were taken out. And I noticed a lot of the trees in here, they girdled them. They didn't even knock them on the ground. There is a ton of firewood in here. I bet they've got, I don't know, over 500 trees laying on the ground. As the morning progresses, it gets later toward morning. The hunters do have to be out of the woods about 1 o'clock. That allows the hens, you know, to find a nest and nest up and start laying their eggs. And they don't want hunters roaming around in the woods kicking the hens off the nest accidentally. But it's only like 8:30 in the morning. But anyway, the closer you get to noon, and start going off the nest, that's when your gobblers can be more apt to come in, because they don't have any hens with them anymore. So this will be an opening day. I may write this out a little bit and just kind of see what happens here. I'm in a really good spot. There's a logging road in front of me. There's a fence row behind me. There's a natural gate. All these ridges come together here. So It's just a travel quarter. I've had deer already come by this morning. And there may be some turkeys coming here pretty soon. We can always hope. The thing you gotta be careful is calling too much. It's just not natural. And an old gobbler, you'll get pretty wise to that pretty quick. But you know, even if I don't see anything today, far as an illegal bird, this is wonderful, just sitting in a turkey blind in the middle of beautiful timber. All the birds are singing. And it's just nice. It's really nice and relaxing. Ben and Isaac, I gave them their plans this morning so they could carry out the chores. So they're solo this morning. I think they were pretty fired up to be on their own. Not to have me with them. And I know they'll do 100%. I am so fortunate to have those two young men. They are awesome. I think they both have a very bright future in front of them, no matter what they decide to do. They're just those kind of fellas that's awesome. Gives you really hope for the next generation, the younger generation. You hear all this stuff about the young people, this and that, but I'm telling you, there's some really, really good ones out there. And I've got two of them. Gosh, such a beautiful morning. All the birds are singing. It's been about probably 15 minutes since I've heard a turkey gobble, so it's just about time to have one gobble. He's been hitting it about every 15 minutes. There's a pileated woodpecker. I've been hearing him this morning up here in the woods. Boy, they're cool. The pileated woodpecker looks almost like a crow flying through the woods. They're monster woodpeckers. Big, long beak on. This woolly woods. I used to come back in here coon hunting 20 years ago, and I used to coon hunt on my mule. But I never came in this woods without a compass, especially in the dark. You'd never get out of here. Because when you get lost in the dark, you don't realize it, but you're making circles. You just walk in circles all night. You gotta have a compass. But I used to catch some coons back in here. I always liked it back here because nobody. It's just such a wild area back here. There's no houses. Nothing. Just creeks. That big lake back there. The coons like to come into that big lake to eat fish and frogs. You can always hit a track over there with your dogs. It's kind of funny, you can sit here for an hour and then all of a sudden you might hear two or three times they'll gobble. It's just kind of the way it goes. I think the hens leave them and then they'll gobble a little bit, then they move on and then they'll gobble. But typically they've got these strutting zones. Right out here to my right is a strutting zone. It looks like a vegetable garden. He's got a rake. It looks like he took a rake and raked up it. It's just beautiful. Beautifully manicured dirt spot with his feet. And there's feathers out there in it where he's been spinning around. And they get up on a high point and they'll strut. The reason they get up on a high point is so all the hens can see them. Because that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to draw hens to them. So you call in a wild turkey to you. You're actually reversing nature. that's what makes it so challenging. But the redbud trees are blooming. The service berries are blooming. It's just a gorgeous time of the year. You can still see through the woods pretty good. But in 10 days, all these big white oaks will be completely leafed out. You won't be able to see anything in here other than right out in front of you. Well, folks, I think I'm going to end my video here. Just all you folks that are subscribed to our channel, thank you. And everyone have a great day. And we'll see y'all down the road. This is Great Judy signing off.